Well, the 2008 flood was at a level that the town had never seen before. In fact, it was 5.5 feet above what the community had ever seen before.
Well, here after 2008, we've lost about 32 homes from that. A lot of them had with the FEMA buyouts, and the people were just getting tired of fighting all the time. Right. We couldn't keep sandbagging, and we knew that. And so we tried to take the next step. Thankfully, a majority of the people took the FEMA offered buyouts, and so we were able to create parks like this and green space up and down the community. You know, this street in particular, we got the community gardens now, and that's good use of the green space. Nobody left the community.
Yeah.
They all stayed. I mean,
that's important.
We've had several disasters. We had the 08 flood, the 16 flood. We had a tornado and a windstorm.
Right.
But our population has never decreased. It's always stayed the same because we are a very, very resilient community. So the best way to not have any more damage is to move the stuff out of the place.
Right.
We have some extreme difficulties with having our utility plant right there. The fire station, we are actually in the process of identified a new piece of property out in the floodplain over on the western edge of town. We're kind of working with the state right now to try and buy that property so we can put it on there, and that's going to be one of the major risks. We can keep one of those critical activities out of our out of the floodplain.
So what we were able to observe here in Vinton, Iowa today is the understanding that mitigation planning and action shouldn't be a one and done affair, that it takes a long-term commitment to create resilience across the nation at the state, local, tribal, and territorial level.